Saad ever? Do you like blood?
Welcome, welcome, ladies
and
gentlemen.
Do you like quizzes?
What?
Do you guys like quizzes?
We just started the podcast, yeah. So
I'm just wondering.
Okay. Yeah, I like quizzes. Anyway, welcome. Yeah, we should do a quiz sometime. Welcome, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Film Game Podcast. I'm your host, Saad. With me, as always, is my man, Jack. And
what's up?
My man, Andre.
What's up?
Okay. So we start this episode like always. We pick five random words from a dictionary and try and come up with a movie out of it. So what speaks to you when you hear the words nacho, dawn, present, scrappy, and chair?
So I'm getting images of like a nacho in a sort of Breaking Dawn fashion. So kind of he's scrapping. It says nacho is probably like scrapping maybe with a chair. It's all, so maybe someone gives a present, which is a nacho.
You say, are we doing another talking animal? What's it called? So yeah, we're doing a talking nacho.
Yeah. The nacho. Is the nacho going to be a gift or a present? Or is the present going to be a chair to a nacho, you know, at the dawn of time? I don't know, you know, it's crazy.
Okay.
But then someone else comes in and they start getting scrappy. I don't know. I mean,
What if we implemented both meanings of present? So maybe the theme would be that you need to stop living in the past and also think about the future, but live in the present, because it's called present because it's a gift. So whoever is the main character learns over the course of film to appreciate the present in spite of all the, I don't know, conflicts and bad stuff that's happening to him or her, and take it as a gift and appreciate the gift that's called present.
Okay, what am I thinking? I'm thinking we have this scrappy nacho. See, the chair could be the present. So we can have this idea of a golden chair and say this nacho has to deliver this golden chair by dawn to become a human. To turn back into a human. Right? Your classic fairy tale. Yeah. Thing. Someone turned this human, this prince, into a nacho. And so the only way to turn back is if he returns a golden chair to this evil wizard or witch by dawn on a particular day. What do you think?
But then what? Do they get scrappy? What, are they called scrappy?
Yeah, he's a scrappy type of dude, you know. He's a bit rough around the edges. Oh, wait, no, that can be his buddy. We do a buddy cop film. It's a buddy cop film set in present day. And it's what? Him and his buddy cop, and they're investigating a thing. And then it turns out it's an evil wizard, and they turn one of them into a nacho. And so...
And his friend Scrappy into salsa.
Yeah. Well, I don't think... He can stay the same.
Okay, cool.
They've got to get along. What do you think about that, Andre?
Hold on.
I'm not sure if we want to do full magic here. Can we make this... What if he thinks he's a nacho? He's not actually.
I like it.
How do we input?
Yeah. What if he thinks he's a nacho living in the... Or what if he thinks he's a nacho living in the past, but at the same time, he's a chair living in the future? So he has to unite those two things to be human again, to be whole. And we can present the nacho and the chair as two opposing values. And the nacho dawns on you, but the chair scrapes. And only by uniting them, you're human. What do you think of that idea, Saad?
I'm not entirely sure what you just said. Okay, so we have this, you know, body cop film with a dude. The question is, do we want him to be a nacho or think he's a nacho? What do you think about that, Jack?
Thank you for having me, Saad. I think that it'd be a really fun idea because making them inanimate objects is really quirky and weird. Will really add to a bit of comedy to it.
So you want the nacho to be real? That he is a nacho?
I mean, personally, I think he should be in a mental asylum and it should be kind of looking into, kind of delving into him as a nacho, thinking it's real, his adventures, but then little things throughout the entire story kind of indicate, at least the audience, that actually he might be just a mental patient.
So we can do an M. Night Shyamalan here. And the big reveal is that he was a human the whole time. He wasn't a nacho.
Yeah. So I mean, goes back into present day, and yeah, scrapping, and every time he scraps, maybe like something happens.
What do you think, Andre? Do you think that's a bit of a touchy subject, potentially? You know, sensitive subject, but it's been done before, right? You've got loads of films like that.
I think if done correctly, it's not going to be cancelled, but on the contrary, it's going to be acclaimed. If it is presented as something as along the lines of mental health is important, maybe he became a nacho because he faced some mental issues, some pressure, and because of that, he started to become a simple nacho as a sort of chase for simplicity, you know? A desire for things to be normal again, to be simple, to be understandable, something like that. I've actually seen a film recently. It's called Identity, and it's directed by James Mangold, who directed Logan, and who's going to direct the upcoming Indiana Jones film. And the film deals with that. It's basically a whodunit story about some guys at a motel, and there are some crimes happening. And at the end, it's revealed that they are all different personalities psychotic killer, something like that. So yeah, we can definitely do that as well.
Yeah, and we can say he's a cop, he's seen some terrible things, and obviously that's affected him.
We could say that he became like that because once after his schedule, you know, his police run thingy, after his job, instead of going home, he saw a dawn so beautiful, and then he saw a chair and he sat on it. And that's his origin story.
But I like the idea of the quest as well. So he, in his mind, to turn back to a human he has to, you know, get this golden chair and give it to this wizard by dawn on like a Saturday or something. And then his partner is just going along with it. But, you know, Shutter Island, right?
Yeah.
So that's kind of what happened there. Obviously, we're trying to find a unique tone here. We're not going full serious. We're just not good enough to go, well, I'm not, to go full serious. Also, it's a Nacho, so we got to find the humor there. But yeah, I like the idea he's going on this quest, and when, to us, it's like filmed like he's a Nacho. And so it's like his adventures. So they've got to interview people, they've got to run into different types of people, they've got to shoot some bad guys, there's a car chase scene, and then ultimately he's got to return this, he finds the golden chair, and then he returns it to the wizard, who turns out to be like a homeless person. Alright.
Oh.
And then it's then we're like, he was a human the whole time.
Yeah, he wasn't a simple Nacho. He was a normal human being. Yeah, yeah. Now the question is, I fully agree. I mean, I'm fine with this story, but we would need to find a villain. And such a story needs a villain that's at the same level with Joker. So someone who argues with logical arguments against the hero's point of view, someone who challenges society itself, you know, he might actually say, we live in a society, you know, or we scrape in a society.
Yeah.
What if his partner is actually the psychologist? Mm-hmm. And actually, you think he's your friend. What if your friend, the one that, is it Scrappy?
He's a Scrappy guy.
Yeah. The one in the Nacho realm or reality, and you think that's like your partner, your friend, but actually it's not. It's a psychologist who's kind of messing you over and is actually your enemy.
So what if this is buddy cop, whether it's the psychologist or whoever, who's helping him on this journey, what if he actually wants the golden chair and it's like a $1 million chair or something?
Yeah, so he's trying to guide him psychologically in his head.
Yeah.
To basically tell him where it is.
What do you think of that, Andre?
Yeah. I'm just thinking if at its core the film is a buddy cop, there should be plenty of scenes in which they do funny, silly stuff, or I don't know, they do stuff together, and this reveal would only be in the end. So until then, they bond, basically. They form a strange but working friendship. And at the end, boom, you know, it all comes crashing down because things are not what they seem. And the psychologist is trying to get the chair for himself.
That would literally mentally scar you, though. That's like love, happiness, sadness, and betrayal. Like, imagine you've delved into this new reality of a Nacho because you're that traumatized, right? Of maybe something's happened and you've obtained something after, say, your family have all died and you've inherited something, which is like the equivalent to like the golden chair, right? And then your psychologist, who you think is helping you in your new reality, your friend, only to find out he's also your enemy.
Yeah.
And it's like
pretty dark.
you then go up a level into human again, or do you go even lower inception wise and go even more into your psyche to avoid the betrayal of what you thought was your partner that you had, that you bonded with on a deep psychological level in your head as a Nacho, and you find out they betray you as well, and then you're even more traumatized, so you go even deeper. And
okay, it is pretty dark. So what if he does the betrayal, but because he's had this whole journey with him, he regrets doing that, the buddy cop psychologist guy. So then
I would advise against it. Ooh. Because then he wouldn't be a villain anymore. He needs to force of negative. Okay, yeah, if we have another villain, then let's do as you say.
Well, I think you can have this as a villain, but you can make the villain empathetic. So again, like, people empathize with Thanos, for example, because it's like, yeah, okay, he's kind of trying to do the right thing, even if it's not necessarily right. He's trying to do what he thinks is the right thing, you know. Or if you see like a villain, like, do you ever watch Naruto?
No.
So Obito, everyone sees him as the villain, but actually he does that because Kakashi literally kills his best friend and girlfriend, or the girl that he loved. Basically, he killed her and basically saw that the world was just going to shit, so he vowed to basically put everyone in an infinite dream, basically. But he's seen as the villain, but actually he did it because he's only seen pain in his entire life and wanted to change it. So actually he wanted to do good, but actually ended up doing it in a way that's like his actions were bad to obtain the good, you know. So actually, if this villain is trying to obtain this thing for good, but actually he's doing it in a bad way.
Could it just be, you know, he's got a sick kid or something simple. He needs the money from the golden chair, and he's going to get the chair and give it to the big bad. And then when he does that, he regrets it. Say our guy gets captured or something, and then he's got to rescue his buddy.
Well, yeah, it could be like he could like heal. He could actually heal, even though someone's done even something like betrayed him, which you'd think would psychologically damage you. But actually, maybe he heals because he's learned to empathize and realize actually he's not the victim. The person who's doing the bad thing is, because actually he wouldn't do bad things unless he was traumatized himself.
Yeah. So, our buddy cop, the psychologist. Wait, we got to decide that. Is he a psychologist or just another cop? Should we just do another cop?
It's up to you.
Yeah, let's just do a cop for now. Yeah.
Well, if we are going to make the film about the mind and mental issues and stuff like that, I think it would be more relevant to have a psychologist, because over the course of the film, he could comment on different issues and themes, and he would be more relevant to the situation at hand. At least that's how I see things. I don't mind a cop either.
Yeah. I guess then, are we doing the full twist? Or if it's from the outset, we know he thinks he's a Nacho and he's trying to find this golden chair. Because if the psychologist is there, he'd obviously be letting the dude know, you're not a Nacho, by the way, or something like that. But then, in Shutter Island, it was a psychologist as well. But anyway, the idea is, so the buddy cop, or buddy psychologist, he wants the golden chair for himself to help his family. So he gets the golden chair, sells it to the mafia, like some gang. Is Jack still there?
Yeah. What, is my camera gone? Is it?
I don't know.
Somebody. Yeah.
He sells the chair, gets the money, goes home. Meanwhile, the Nacho dude is taken in. He's distraught. his whole world has changed. He realizes, maybe at that point, he realizes he might not be a Nacho something. And then our dude who betrayed him comes into the gang's hideout. We do like a shootout scene. And then, but our guy, and then he saves the day, and then they're buddies again. And then the Nacho guy realizes, I'm not a Nacho. You can take that golden chair and you can give it to your family. You can use it to help your family or something.
Oh, I see.
So he gets the present that he wanted. He wanted that golden chair to turn into a human again. But he realizes
He didn't need it anymore. I see.
So he was looking into the...
for everyone.
Yeah, he was looking into the future. But the present is... It's the friends we made along the way. It's not the golden chair. It's the friends we made along the way. Let's go. Cut the check.
Damn, man. Another successful film.
What do you think, Jack?
I think it has potential. I think it could genuinely... It could genuinely be a... Jojo Rabbit sort of film, or Perks Being a Wallflower film, or, you know, Perks Being a Wallflower, definitely that whole psychological twist. Like, what was who's the director of Jojo Rabbit again?
Taika Waititi.
Yeah, it seems like a very potentially like a Taika Waititi film, or
or a James Gunn.
What's that?
James Gunn.
The director of Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yeah. Like, it could actually have quite... It could basically be deep. So I think personally, the best films are ones that can be quite complex and not just one-dimensional. So they can be quite sad and full of betrayal and love and happiness and wonder and kind of... spectacular things, but also but like funny and heavy, funny and light, but also can go quite heavy and dark, you know. And I think those kind of balances are quite nice. So I think this has potential.
Yeah. And who do we want the bad guy, the gang member? I guess like we won't see him that much.
So what do they mean by who? Do you mean as the type of personality or celebrity?
The personality, like what's...
Let's go with someone who... a psychologist. Who's a professional... swimmer.
Okay.
So what did we have? We had Dawn. Why not have a scraper? A scrapper. Someone who's like, I don't know what it actually means, but I know it's a thing, right? You can be a scrapper or a scraper. I don't know.
It just means like you're up for a fight or you're kind of messy.
Street fighter.
Yeah, a little scrappy.
Very well. You know, in the 80s, there was actually a film with Clint Eastwood. Do you guys know Clint Eastwood? The Macho Man. Anyway, the guy from Westerns and that tough guy who, even to this day, he's 80, 90 something, I think. And this year he's going to release a film which he directed and also he starred in. Anyway, in the 80s, he made a film just like us, a very random film in which he plays a scraper, basically someone who fights other people for money, for bets. And he has an orangutan and he decides in the middle of the film, I don't know what the main objective was, but in the middle of the film, he decides not to pursue that objective, but to actually take the orangutan to meet his soulmate. So until the end of the film, he completely forgets and doesn't acknowledge at all the first objective. and he just takes the orangutan, and that's it. The film ends.
That's funny.
So
that's
Yeah.
That's like the Seth Rogen's thing. Like, I was watching an interview. He was like, the goal at the start, and then you have something in the background. But by the end of the film, the thing in the background was the real goal, and the goal was like secondary. Yeah. So let's summarize this. We got this this cop, this police guy who's seen some terrible things, and as a result, he's going through an episode where he thinks he's a Nacho. He's been turned into a Nacho by an evil witch and wizard. A couple. Let's do that. So an evil husband and wife, witch and wizard. So they tell him that he has to return a golden chair to them by dawn on the next month, the Saturday, the first Saturday of the next month, right? So he gets his friend, he's like, dude, I'm a Nacho, I can't walk. He's like, I'm so fragile, like, I'm gonna break. Like, he thinks he's like afraid of like seagulls and stuff. But yeah, so his cop is like, his mate is like, listen, dude, I guess how are we gonna break that it's a twist? But anyway, he joins along, he helps him find, they go on an adventure, they find a treasure map, maybe. Where is this this chair? What do you think this golden chair is?
Who is that guy who bins yarn in fairy tales? Rumpelstiltskin.
Yeah. Yeah.
Owns the chair and is sitting on it or owns it.
Yeah.
Don't know.
I think it would be a temple, or instead of something very special, it's just a house, and he goes to a kitchen. And he sees the chair and he grabs it.
Yeah.
Well, so it's just like an old granny's home and she's just using it to change a light bulb or something. And she's just like, oh, this old thing. Yeah, sure.
She's like, can I have it? She's like, yeah, right.
Yeah. Or what if the chair was at his place the entire time?
Inception. I like it.
Yeah.
Dun, dun, dun. What do you think?
Bitching.
All right. So the other idea is the golden chair is like some actors. It's like a stage prop. Nah. Yeah, it could be like he's trying to, maybe he's forgotten, he knows where it is, but he's just trying to piece it together. He's got like a treasure map.
Yeah.
Or the wizard, the evil wizard gives him like directions to it. Oh, yeah. Could we just do a whole heist thing where they take it from a museum?
I think it would work, but usually heist films can't get any deep because they focus on very practical things, like actually taking that stuff. And while I agree that they could get deep, it's always the heist itself that's the priority.
Yeah. What do you think, Jack?
Yes.
Okay. Well, yeah, so they go on this quest. The dude helps them along. Pretty soon in, let's say midway in, we realize he's not actually a Nacho. But then, yeah, they like interview people, you know, like Bad Boys, where they go out and they interview people and they're trying to find where this chair is. And then ultimately, yeah, it could just be it's in someone's auntie's living room and they give it to him.
Yeah.
They give it to him for free. He gets the chair and he hands it to, I guess, why would the, yeah, the auntie's like really nice and she gives it to him instead of them like stealing it. Or could they just steal it from like some old lady's house? And then like in the end, they give it back to her. But then she's like, you can keep it. Right?
Yeah, let's stick with the... I mean, I don't know.
What do you say, Jack?
I say... Did you know there's a bar tab of a 1787 farewell party for George Washington intact still? According to the bill, the founding fathers drank 54 bottles of Madeira, 60 bottles of claret, 8 bottles of whiskey, 22 bottles of porter, 8 bottles of hard cider, 12 of beer, and 7 bowls of alcoholic punch, and there were only 55 attendees.
Ooh. It's horrifying. Let's just do that. Unless you got any better ideas, they'd go on this adventure, they interview people, then they get a lead that this old granny's got it. She's got this expensive golden chair in her house. They steal it from her house. They go back to find the evil witch, which turns out to just be some homeless lady.
Is this like, is he basically like doing all this in real life, but in his head he's a Nacho doing all this?
Yeah.
And so he's just going into a poor old lady's house.
Yeah. And he's like,
he's got a partner who's evil on the real, in reality, but in his fantasy, he's his like partner helping him from an evil witch. And it's actually a robber who's just stealing an old woman's chair.
Yeah. And it's like, he's like, he thinks he's a Nacho. So he's like, give me a lift. Lift me up. He's like...
Yeah, so this old lady's just like, what are you guys doing? And it's just like, quick, lift me, lift me. And he's like, not having to move anywhere.
Yeah. Okay. So they grab the chair. They take it to the homeless person who the guy thinks is a witch. At this point, our dude is like, that's an expensive chair, man. We're not going to give it to some homeless guy. I've got a kid at home. I need this money. I'm taking the chair. He grabs the chair away. He finds these just like gang members. And he's like, you want to buy this golden chair off me or something? They take it, and then Nacho Man goes and gets out of the car, and then he attacks the gang members or something, and then they take him in or something like that. And then the buddy cop doesn't realize he's done that. He's gone after the thing. So he goes home with the money, but then like he hears that he's been taken or something. So then he goes into the gang's hideout. They do a shootout. So we get some other cops in. Maybe not even a shootout, something silly, like a trade or something. Or you just beat some up, like not necessarily like shoot, I don't know. Something beats them up, saves his mate Nacho-Man. Nacho-Man, who feels his friend has betrayed him. He's been through traumatic stuff as well. But the buddy cop tells him, I was doing this for my kid. I needed the chair. But, you know, it is what it is. Nacho-Man realizes it's like past dawn or something, and he's like, oh no, I didn't give the chair in on time or something, they didn't sit on the chair at dawn time, and I'm going to be a Nacho. But then like he realizes I'm not actually a Nacho, and then yeah, they take the chair, give it back to the old lady, but then she's like, you can keep it. Turns out she's a fairy.
I think this is a film right there, a great film. What else is there for me to say? Like, it's while I can see a really well developed film in what you just said, I think we should think before that about the general themes and messages and emotions that we want to transmit, and then figure out the actual plot. So having said that, let's scrap everything you just said. Start from zero. I'm kidding. But yeah, man.
Okay.
Start from the beginning.
We also need to think about an end credit scene. And I got the best one. It's a fridge on a boat,
full of
rats, and there's also a ninja pineapple over there. And they say, listen guys, we need to be together because 5 films from now on, all of our connections are going to make sense because some sort of a Thanos villain is going to threaten us all and we'll need to unite in order to defeat him.
Okay, so what do we want to call our film? Something like Nacho-Man?
Yeah, Nacho-Man. That sounds...
Yeah. Obviously, there's Nacho Libre, but I think there's room for 2 Nacho films out there. What do you think, Jack?
That's a Nacho Libre film? I didn't know.
Or Jack Black.
Yeah. Not really...
Nacho-Man. Huh?
Nacho versus Scrappy.
I say Nacho-Man and the Golden Chair or something like that.
Or, since we already have the word Dawn, let's make it Nacho v. Scrappy, Dawn of Chairs.
Yeah. Something like that. All right, Nacho-Man. Who do we want to... who's going to star in this? Who's going to be Nacho-Man? I think there's only one option, really.
Shia LaBeouf.
Yeah. Okay. Who's going to be the buddy cop / betrayer / redeemer in the end?
Whom would we want to see Shia LaBeouf interact with? Like, who would suit him in a buddy cop?
I think Jackie Chan.
Yeah. I was going to say, let's not go with the obvious answer. Like, Adam Driver, you know, someone like that. Let's go with the less obvious, but at the same time, just as correct answer. Jackie Chan, maybe, yeah.
Or younger.
But I think we can go even further.
Like Donnie Yen?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Donnie. Yeah. Or Helen Mirren, you know, someone like that. Or Vin Diesel.
Yeah. There's a lot of options there. Which one do we go for?
Let's go for, let me think, Christopher Nolan. This could be the actual start of his acting career. You know, he could start his acting career with a bang. So by all means, let's go with Christopher Nolan. Christopher Nolan and Shia LaBeouf. How can you say no to that?
Okay. And who's directing this? Taika Waititi, I think we established. Yeah.
Again, let's not go with the obvious answer. Like, yeah, Taika Waititi is perfect, but let's look for the underdog. Let me think for a bit. John Cena, you know?
Okay.
This could be the film that kickstarts two great careers, the acting career of Christopher Nolan and the directing career of John Cena. And just imagine Shia LaBeouf interacting, having chemistry with Christopher Nolan in a film directed by John Cena. How can you say no to that? Like, before its release, people are going to send Oscars to it. Like, all the festivals are going to send their awards to the producers, to us, because of such a great film. So, yeah, if you ask me, these are my options. LaBeouf, Nolan, and Cena.
Why have I heard of Christopher Nolan?
What?
Why have I heard of Christopher Nolan?
What? He directed Interstellar, Inception, The Dark Knight trilogy.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Really good films.
Yeah.
And, who do we want to play, like, the evil wizard or witch? Who's actually a homeless person.
What?
Helen Mirren could work. Yeah.
Or Miley Cyrus.
Miley Cyrus, okay.
Miley Cyrus, yeah.
Miley Cyrus would actually make a very good witch.
No, that's your paranoia speaking. There's no agenda here. I'm simply trying to understand what happened.
You can't understand what happened. You will never understand what I'm going
through. Maybe.
No, not maybe.
No, maybe. Never. I can understand guilt. I can understand regret. I can understand betrayal. These are all human conditions.
I think, you know, clarity and knowing what you want, you're able to make each day count.
Nacho-Man.